Okay, yeah, people, we also have Hepzibah here, Varice record label. Say hi to us, people.
What's happening, my people?
Okay,
here we are in the city of Lagos doing what we are purposed to do.
Okay, nice having you here. So, real quick, I want to know, please, can you explain what it means for a son of God to be bad? What does it mean to be a bad son of God? Please, can you clarify that for us? Because so that some of us might not be getting the wrong message or saying, what's this song all about? So can you just clarify what it means to be a bad son of God?
Sure. Just as my great colleague, Little Ray, had mentioned, I believe, earlier in the interview. Basically, the word bad means extraordinarily excellent. So you see, because we're human beings, we have to be able to quantify something, what we're saying. You know, so we have to put a tag to how good something is supposed to be so we can understand it. So that's why in the streets, when somebody says something is really, really good, I mean, they give you respect, they say it's bad. So because of that, we let people know that everything to do with the Son of God is good, positive, great, excellent, incredible. Now the dictionary says the word bad is extraordinarily excellent. So rather than people think negative of the word bad, S-O-G, it's actually really positive. It actually means the best the human mind could possibly imagine. So that's when you say you're a bad son of God. You are just more than any human being can imagine or think. You know, and I know, let me just segue because, you know, people might want to say, well, what is the song all about? The song has something for everybody. So we're talking to everybody at every point of their walk in this life. But we also pick an example of a local stud that he thinks all his abilities are, all his great abilities that he's been using to be successful is all because of just, he just has it. He just has it in him. And he's successful because he, you know, his goal is to get as many women as possible and just popular. So he's getting all that. But he doesn't realize that there's so much more to him than that. You know, and we're here to tell him that, boy, you know, you're actually really, really blessed because God gave you so many of these skills and gifts, but you're using them in the wrong direction and you have actually succeeded with them. Can you imagine if you actually follow the purpose that you were created for? Can you actually imagine that if you actually say, you know what, God, you created me, so I am going to do what you've created me to do. I am going to say yes to you, my God. I'm going to say yes to you, Jesus. And I'm going to say all these gifts that you gave me, channel them in how I was planned. Them. And so part of that is that they have to conform to the image of God so that they can soar, arise, and shine. That's on one aspect. We use the example of a negative bad guy realizing that he needs to be really embrace the Son of God who he potentially was predestined to be, to do that in order to soar. And then we now tell everybody, in all walks of life, we're all at different levels. So, but the truth of the matter is that we were all born and predestined to be sons of God only if we can say, yes, I accept you, my God, into my life. And I will now be able to walk as my son of God. I will now be able to walk with all the power that he has given us. So we are now saying, everybody in every walk of life, you are a son of God. You are bad because you are extraordinarily excellent. And you're especially bad, extraordinarily excellent, not because of the abilities you have, not because of your looks, not because of anything, but because you are the Son of God and all power has been given to the Son of God as they walk by the Spirit in who they are called to be. I think that's it.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you. That's, I believe they will gladly and they will surely understand that because you really explained it. Okay, what brought about the inspiration of SOG?
I mean, S-O-G really, the word the Son of God, as you know, the Bible says the Son of God, which is Jesus, has all authority, all power on earth has been given to him. And because the Son of God is considered our elderly brother, our father, we are supposed to know that we are sons of God. We are supposed to know that as we imbibe and become the Son of God, what and who we're created to be, there's no power that can contend with us, and everything we do is sought. So it was so imperative to remind everybody that there's so much good in us, there's so much greatness in us. So we don't need to compete with one another. We don't need to feel inferior. We don't need to feel because we were born a little bit disadvantaged, we're not as good as anything else. You are the best. If you said yes to Jesus, if you said, yes, I believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God, so that makes me a son of God. And therefore, I can mount up with wings like eagles, run and not be weary, and walk and not fall. So we have to share that. We have to let people know they are so much greater than they might think they are. And it's important to get on track, work in purpose, and soar.
Okay. Thank you very much. Okay. One word or one message can you tag SOG?
How would I say summarize it? Is that your question?
Yes, how would you summarize it?
Well, I would say the messages of SOG, which says you are the Son of God, you are an SOG. It's the everlasting open doors for each and every one of us. So I would coin it open doors. Once you get it, all the windows of heaven will be open to you, and it's all blessings, because if you will be able to understand what the equation is and how to live, walk, and be empowered